Hey guys, sup? I know it's been a while. Sorry. The editor got sick. What can you do? But hey, now we're back and ready with a new episode. But first, there's a little matter we need to address. Isn't that right, sis?
I just don't understand. It's impossible. This can't happen. This never happens!
So, last episode we decided to hold us a poll, yeah? We asked you guys to vote for your personal best girl of Kaguya-sama, Love is War. Hayasaka Ai or Fujiwara Chika? I also threw Kaguya herself in there, just for giggles. I said it was obviously Hayasaka, but Rila just had to go and fight me on that one. Well, now the results are in, and hey, would you look at that? I spy with my little eye a landslide victory for yours truly! What do you say to that, sis?
Doesn't make any sense. I can't lose. I always win. I always come out on top. This is messing up the whole order of things.
Rila?
It's a mistake. A glitch. That's the only way this could happen.
Rila!
I'll just check the YouTube stats again and...
Rila!
Eh? What? Where am I? What happened? Huh? Riley?
Nice of you to join us here on planet Earth, sis.
Riley, this is no time for your jokes! This is a travesty! I lost! To you! How can this happen?
Would you prefer if I kick your ass at a fighting game?
Yes! I'm terrible at those! That at least makes sense! This is the worst feeling!
Alright, gloating later then. For now, damage control. Hey Rila, you know what today's episode's supposed to be, right?
I don't know.
Starts with an F.
Fully Cooly?
No, that's next season. Probably.
Fruits Basket?
No. You're on your own with that one. There it is.
Flip Flappers!
Yeah. March of the Magical Girls might be long over, but no one said we can only talk about magical girls in March, right?
Right! Yes! Let's do this!
Somehow I knew that'd be your answer. Well, hope you guys are ready to tune in. I'm Riley.
I'm excited!
And you're watching Bulletoon! Actually, now that I think about it, I haven't watched this one since it came out. How do we even pick a topic?
That's fine. I remember all of it. Every detail. Perfectly.
You know, that genius IQ of yours would be scary if you cared about literally anything else.
So, remember how we finally got to talk about Yuki Yuna a while ago?
Please don't remind me. Pretty sure my ears are still ringing.
So rude. But good, you do remember. So back in that episode, we mentioned how a lot of being a magical girl is about sacrifice.
Well, it's not untrue. I know people tend to lump that in with Yuki Yuna and Madoka Magica and all that, but it's a theme that's been around in the genre since at least Sailor Moon. The newer age of darker magical girl stories just kinda made people more wary about it. So every time something has a magical girl tag, you just kind of expect things to get really messed up really quickly.
Right. And Flip Flappers is no different.
I don't know, that seems like a bit of a stretch.
It isn't though. It's not quite as literal about it as Yuki Yuna, but at the end of the day, Flip Flappers is all about sacrifice.
I'm not seeing it.
Well then, aren't you lucky to have such an awesome big sis?
For the millionth time, we are twins!
Details. Anyway, Yuki Yuna is basically a series that calls out the more destructive side of the all-loving, self-sacrificing kind of heroism we tend to see in a lot of the magical girl genre. And its final message is that caring about others is great, but you should still take care of yourself.
Right. Like we mentioned then, the idea is that it's fine to be selfish every now and then, as long as you're willing to deal with whatever that means in the end. But I don't really get how that's similar to Flip Flappers at all.
What does Yuna do at the end of the second season?
She chooses life over being a human sacrifice?
Exactly. She makes a choice. And that's what Flip Flappers is all about. The choices we make.
Oh, okay. I get where you're coming from. Basically, when you make a choice, you may end up sacrificing one thing for another.
Flip Flappers is all about living with your decisions. It's all over the series. But most importantly, it's the whole point of Kokona's character arc.
That's a good point. They even flat out say as much in the end. Kokona was pretty much a living doll. She just let herself be swept up in the current, blending into the background, never really developing a presence of her own. She was afraid to make choices because she didn't want to regret them.
Yep, and the whole arc is emphasized by all these other characters with really different perspectives on that. Like Papika, she was a total dynamo. She had all the personality in the world and she was so bold. She made choices willy-nilly, almost never regretting anything at all.
Which is the opposite extreme and probably the closest thing she has to a character arc of her own. Learning to actually consider her decisions a little more and also respect the decisions of others. But it really isn't as pronounced a change as Kokona's. The two of them sorta level out a bit, if anything.
True. A lot of the other characters show the darker side of Kokona's desire to let herself be controlled. Yayaka never really had any control. And when she finally did start making her own decisions, things really turned around for her.
Yeah, she even got a magical girl transformation like the other two, which is actually a pretty big deal when you think about it. The transformations in the magical girl genre are more and more coming to represent more than just what they always did in traditional shows. Here, they're representations of the characters making those choices. Every time Kokona does it, it's representing her decision to finally step up and stop letting herself be a puppet or a slave to circumstances. Her choice to take action. And it's basically the same for Yayaka. She doesn't get her transformation until after she finally makes a choice of her own, one not dictated by her orders.
There's also the more extreme case of Kokona's mom. Mimi never had a choice in anything. She was the ultimate victim of that whole cycle. But if there was one thing she was going to be able to control, it would have to be her daughter. Ultimately, that lack of control basically drove her insane, and she disappeared into a reality where she was God. Her choice overruled all. But then there's one other character whose choices are really important. Kokona's papa, Salt. He's really cagey and mysterious about it for most of the series, but it's pretty easy to pick up on. Anyway, Salt represents the opposite end of things. He had choices. Unfortunately for him, he didn't make the best ones, and he wound up regretting them.
He spends damn near the entire series basically trying to make up for it, all leading up to the one key moment that punctuates his whole arc.
The series does a really great job of showing the nuance of choice and how the choices we make define us. Using a magical girl spin just gives me all the more reason to adore it.
Yeah, though I hesitate to really call it a magical girl show. They don't spend nearly as much time transformed as you might think. If anything, it's kind of a weird play on Alice in Wonderland, too.
It kind of is. It's like a sort of light isekai series with a magical girl twist in a way. And that makes it a really fun adventure. Ooh, you could even call it a bizarre adventure, right? Get it? Coco's.
All right, I'm putting moratorium on that one right now, thanks.
How mean. Anyway, in the end, Kokona decides that she wants to go on more adventures with Papika. She wants to live her life, make those choices. Even if that means regretting some of them and having to live with them. For as huge as the scale of the story is, and how zany and weird it gets.
And Christ, is it an acid trip and a half. I ain't kidding.
It's actually really down to earth in its themes. Probably even more so than a lot of other magical girl shows.
Honestly, wasn't expecting to be able to say much about this one at all. I mean, aside from how weird it could get.
But the weirdness is part of the fun, and that's why I love it. But what about you all? What do you think of Flip Flappers?
Let us know down below. Oh, and why not also drop in a few suggestions for Rila's costume?
Eh?
Yeah, remember? You said the loser of the poll had to cosplay as anything the winner chooses.
Oh, right. Okay.
What the hell do you mean, okay?
I mean, go ahead and pick something, silly.
Okay, fine. Then how about, I got it.
What is it?
Damn it, that little devil played me! Can't make her dress up in anything she'd be embarrassed to be seen in. How do you embarrass someone who has no shame? She wins even if she loses!
Your face is so funny right now, Riley. You look like you're about to blow a fuse. Is something wrong?
You know damn well what's wrong, you little gremlin!
I'm sure I have no idea what you're talking about.
Damn it! No, whatever already! Give the like button a zap, subscribe, ring the bell. All our links are in the description. Beat it!
so rude to our audience. That'll never do. Sorry about her, everyone, but next time should be fun. Stay tuned!